Hello students, today we will start the new lesson, that is second lesson, We Are Not Afraid to Die, If We Can All Be Together, that is written by Gordon Cook and Ada List. As the title of the lesson is giving, We Are Not Afraid to Die, If We Can All Be Together. So it is only showing the courage, the bravery, the boldness, the optimism, that if the whole family, if a particular group is together, they can fight with anything, and they are even not afraid to die. If someone determined, with optimism, with determination, with strong willpower, so they can even fight with the death. And that has been given also in this lesson. This is the main theme of the story also, that with a strong will to live, with optimism, with bravery, and also handling the minds in the direst stress, you can even win from the death, and you can also cure even the biggest disease like coronavirus. So firstly, to continue about the Gordon Cook, the main writer of the story. Gordon Cook, who was a Canadian, was born in 1978. And he's also brave, like his story. He was also a captain. He had also represented his own country. He's a sailor in Olympics. So in Olympics, he represented his own country in 2008. That's another thing. He couldn't qualify for the final round, but he again represented his country in 2012, and he participated, he qualified for the final round, but he couldn't win a medal. That's another thing. But a story written by him, that is, We Are Not Afraid to Die, If We Can All Be Together, that is a touching story that can touch your heart, that what a beautiful story he has written. So it is the story about the captain, Gordon Cook, that how did he sail, or how did he made a journey on sea with the help of a ship or a boat, and how did he make a round of the world. And during that time, how he struggled for his life. So let's start with the story. In July 1976, the captain, or the author, as a captain, he is telling that in July 1976, my wife Mary, son Jonathan, 6, daughter Suzanne, 7, and I set sail from Plymouth, England, to duplicate the round the world voyage made 200 years earlier by Captain James Cook. So the author is telling through the story of a captain that in 1976 he himself, his wife Mary, his son Jonathan, who was only of 6 years, daughter Suzanne, and she was only of 7 years, and I set sail. And he himself set sail. Sail means the visit of sea journey. So they started their journey from Plymouth, England. And they started their journey from Plymouth, England. To duplicate means to copy in the same way one has done. So they wanted to repeat the round the world voyage. The round of the world, the voyage. Voyage means the sea journey. So in the same manner as he had started the journey, already a person had visited in the same way, made 200 years, and that was done 200 years back earlier by Captain James Cook. And it was done by Captain James Cook 200 years earlier than it. So he wanted to repeat, like Captain James Cook that how he had visited through sea, he would also repeat the journey. Why the person like this captain? They do for the name, fame, and money also. So he had also done this. Also, there is such an enthusiasm, josh, junoon, that also is in some persons, and that's why he also started. He also wanted to repeat the journey. That if he could do, I can also do. So for the longest time, he is telling that how he had prepared for this long journey of the sea voyage. For the longest time, Mary and I. Now he is telling that he and his wife Mary, for a long time, he is telling about himself that he was a 37-year-old businessman, had dreamed of sailing in the wake of the famous explorer. That they had already dreamt about that they would also sail, they would also do the sea journey in the same way that the famous explorer or the Captain James Cook had done. So whatever that famous explorer Captain James Cook had done 200 years earlier, because he had visited the whole world on sea or on a ship, he also wanted to repeat that. And for the past 16 years, we had spent all our leisure time. And now he is saying that from the last 16 years, you can imagine that is not less than a war. They were starting, they had prepared themselves for 16 long years. 16 saal tak mehnat kar rahe hain, you are just preparing for a particular exam for 1 year, 2 year or 3 year. And they were preparing for 16 years to make sea journey, to make the world journey. So he is telling, and for the past 16 years we had spent all our leisure time, they had spent all their leisure. Leisure is related to comfort time, like after your all activities, whatever the comfortable time you want to enjoy, watching cricket, playing TV, playing cricket or watching TV. So in that way, whatever the comfort or leisure time he had, instead of enjoying that, he had spent that in owning. Owning means improving something. Our seafaring skills, that how to go far in sea. Samudra mein dur jaane ki jo unki skills thi, unka talent tha, that was improved by them. And they had spent their much time in that. Because he was only a businessman, as it has been explained, a 37-year-old businessman. And that was the improvement was done in British waters. So they had honed their skills in British waters. British waters here means the sea related, that is nearby British. As you know, the British or the England is surrounded by the sea water. So they were improving their seafar skills for the last 16 years. So here is an idea in the very first paragraph that what is going to happen. A businessman only of 37 years with his family, they had planned to make a worldwide sea journey, pure sansar ki yatra, wo bhi samudri tarike se. That was their plan. And they had spent 16 years for that. Now he is telling about the boat, that what type of boat they have. Our boat Wave Walker. So what was the name of the boat? And the name of the boat was a Wave Walker. It was a 23 meter long, 30 ton wooden hulled beauty. And that was wooden hulled, means made of wooden hull, a type of furniture. So wooden boards, you can say. So that was made of wooden board, and that was having a weight of 30 ton. So 30 ton in weight and 23 meter long. You can imagine 23 meter, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, and 2300 centimeter. That was such a long ship, that was, or boat that was and also having the weight of 30 ton, and that was also beautiful, had been professionally built, and that was not amateurly built, that was professionally built. It means a type of professional persons had also built that, because they were going for sea journey, and there on the way there were so many storms could come in the sea. Samudra mein tufaan bahut aate hain, as you know. So they were ready for that, and we had spent months fitting it out. And he is saying that they had, it means the professionals, and he himself was also, as he was also a sailor as well as captain, so he had also spent months fitting it out. काफ़ी महीने इसको केवल केवल और केवल शिप तैयार करने के लिए, बोट तैयार करने के लिए लगाए गए, एंड टेस्टिंग इन द रफेस्ट वेदर वी कुड फाइंड, एंड वॉट एवर द रफेस्ट वेदर, रफेस्ट वेदर हेयर मीन्स द रफ और द बैड वेदर, कितना भी ख़राब मौसम मिला उसी के अंदर वो चले गए सी के अंदर दूर तक, सो दैट दे कुड टेस्ट देयर शिप. सो दैट वॉज द प्रिपेयर ness for them, that how long time they had spent, 16 years, and the wave walker, the their ship, their boat, that was also prepared. So in that way everything was prepared for them. Now they had started. So the author is telling the first leg of their journey, it means the first part of their journey, planned 3 years, it means they had planned for 3 years journey. It was not a journey of a few days, but that was a journey of long 3 years. That was the whole part was 1,05,000 kilometers. So the first leg of our planned 3 year 1,05,000 kilometer journey passed pleasantly. So the first part that was planned, that gone very pleasantly, in a very pleasant manner, in a enjoyable manner. As we sailed down in the west coast of Africa to Cape Town, because they had sailed down to the west coast of Africa to Cape Town. So firstly they had started their journey from where? That was started from Plymouth, that has been mentioned. Yes, they had started in the very starting, it has been given that they had started from Plymouth, England. So they had started their journey from Plymouth, England, and now they have reached where? That is Africa, Cape Town. So they now landed for Cape Town. So that was the first part of their journey. How many parts, that has not been mentioned, but in the story, if we mention that there was a pleasant, as it has been mentioned, it was passed in pleasant manner. So the first part, or the pleasant memories of their journey, that was the only the first part. After that they had struggled, and after that how did they save themselves. So you can part their journey, whatever the journey they had done, that was in three parts. So here we can say the first part of their journey was very comfortable, and they were very excited to go. They were full of optimism that they could even go all round of the world. But what happened the next? There before heading east, so when they reached at Cape Town, and before heading towards east, we took on two crewmen. They had taken two crewmen, sailors. So for the extra help, and who were they? American Larry Vigil. It means they were also not you can say unknown person. They were also matured, experienced person, and one of them was from America, whose name was Larry Vigil, and the second was Swiss related to that is Switzerland. So one was Swiss, and his name was Hubbs Sisler. So these were the two expert, you can say, crewmen for the sailors who were going to help them in the next part of their journey, to help us to tackle one of the world's roughest seas, that was the Southern Indian Ocean. So they had started their journey from Cape Town, but they had taken two specialist crewmen, and they were, the first one is American Larry Vigil, and the second one was Swiss Herb Schisler. So both were taken for what? To help them to tackle or to deal one of the world's roughest seas. It is supposed that the Southern Indian Ocean is the roughest sea, where so many different storms always come. So that's why they had taken such two persons, two crewmen, who could help them in the sea journey.